welcome to Viewpoint. My name is Vladimir Solovub, and right now I'm joined by the project manager of the World Bank Group project, Ukraine Residential Energy Efficiency, Mr. Grzegorz Gajda. Mr. Gajda, welcome to Viewpoint.
Good morning.
Mr. Gajda, you have almost 15 years of experience supervising the financing of municipal infrastructure projects, working for major foreign and international financing institutions in Poland and Ukraine. And recently you wrote an article criticizing the Ukrainian government for mishandling the housing, residential and energy consumption approach in Ukraine. So, you said in that article that this approach is very much outdated, it's going back from the Soviet times. So can you tell us and our viewers very briefly, what is so terribly wrong with Ukrainian residential energy consumption?
Well, the energy consumption in Ukrainian housing sector is very high. It's equivalent of 20 billion cubic meters of natural gas. It's nearly half of Ukrainian gas consumption. That's a lot. This gas, this imported energy resource is very costly for Ukraine as a country.
And, I'm sorry, can you tell us like in perspective, so or in comparison, what is this consumption rate in other countries? So in Ukraine, I understand it's almost half of the consumption of all the gas consumption for the residential purposes. What is the situation in other countries?
Well, we can compare it with Poland. Poland consumes in total, country of pretty much the same population, consumes 17.5 billion cubic meters of natural gas. So less than Ukrainian housing sector alone.
What about in percentage? How much is that in percentage?
In percentage, it's pretty much the same. So the percentage.
So it's also half of the natural gas consumption.
But the scale of it is substantially higher. It's two to three times higher than in comparable countries in Central Western Europe.
And so again, going back to the problems with Ukrainian energy consumption, it is high. What are the other problems?
Yeah, and for the last 20 years, nothing has changed. So basically, nothing has been done to reduce consumption over the last 20 years. So basically, we have seen that consumption of energy in the sector basically stays still. Nothing is being reduced, although the prices were steadily going up. So there are some systemic problems, and I'm going to talk a little bit about the systemic problems we can see. Basically, the first thing that we need to understand is that all residential housing stock in Ukraine is privately owned. All multifamily apartment buildings are private property of the owners of individual apartments in those buildings. So it is them, the private owners, who are responsible for maintaining and investing in those apartment buildings. Their consumption.
Yeah, but they are paying the utility providers, the utility service providers, who are vested with the task of maintaining the overall apartment blocks. Isn't that
right?
Isn't that correct?
They are paying.
Yes.
However, very often this becomes like without any contract. So back from communist times, municipal housing management companies called ZHEKs manage these buildings. With privatization of the housing stock that happened in early 90s, we now have private buildings and municipal companies, and the management function is provided to those buildings without any contract. So people pay without contract.
Yeah, companies. I think in Ukraine it's called something being on the balance. These houses are being on the balance of these municipally owned utility service providers.
Yeah, well, we heard this kind of description on the balance, but if we compare it with our cars, we own our cars. They are not on the balance of someone else. I own my car. I fill it with petrol. I don't have anybody to keep my car on his balance.
Yeah, but your car is an independent asset. You can do with your car whatever you want, and that's totally different with the apartment block. You cannot take your apartment out of the entire building.
What
so that's
talking,
why you're dependent on the entire building.
What we are talking building. Is the building itself. So it's actually a very valid point that you just made, is that apartments are not separable from each other. They are all together inside the building. So the key to understand the situation is to understand that the building is one unit, one object that has to be managed by its owners collectively. So once we understand that, the second thing to understand is that it's private property of this group of people who owns the apartment, individual apartments in this building. And there is no thing such as a balance.
So basically, Mr. Gajda, what you're saying is that the owners of all the apartments which are in a particular building have to come together, create some sort of union, and then manage their property, which they own collectively.
Precisely. And actually,
why is this not being done?
Well, actually, this has just been done. In July this year, a special law entered into force in Ukraine, a law that we spent a few years and our predecessors, other international finance organizations were helping in preparation of this law. Law that basically regulates the property relationship in a multifamily building. This law entered into force in July this year, and it requires residents to form unions, or in another way, get together and collectively decide what is going to happen with their building.
So basically the problem was that there was no legal basis for the residents, for the people to do that.
The legal basis was there, but it was not good enough. So it only gave a couple of buildings an opportunity to create such a union, which is called Homeowners Association in Ukraine. And this Homeowners Association can take over management of those buildings.
How would you characterize this law, which this bill, which has been passed recently? Is it good enough for the bill, for the owners, for the residents to take the matters into their own hands?
Yeah, it's a good law. It has three specific characteristics that make it a good law. They basically provide for a decision be taken by simple majority, so rather in an efficient way. Previously, 100% was required to take decisions in a multifamily building. So here now we have simple majority. Second thing is that whenever decision is taken, everybody is responsible of paying the amount that has been decided, say for maintenance or for repairs or for the loan which has been taken for repair of the building. And third thing is that there is no way an apartment owner can say, I was not voting, I was not present at the meeting, I was against, and this would release him from his duty to being responsible for the decisions that have been taken by the majority.
But doesn't that create a risk that a couple of apartment owners will form some sort of their union or alliance, and they will enter into contracts with the utility providers, service providers, who are beneficial to them, but not might be beneficial to other apartment owners. And then they say, well, we are the union, we created the union, we enter into the contract with this provider, you have to abide.
Well, it's majority which decides. So what is required is that these people should have majority in the building. And actually, whenever there is a decision to be taken, there are always people who are against it. So the majority principle is very well working elsewhere, in Western Europe, in United States, in countries even like India or China. So this is the principle that has been already tried and tested elsewhere. We are not trying to reinvent
the
wheel.
What about the municipalities? Obviously, they must not be happy with this law, because previously all the money which were being paid by the apartment owners, they went to these utility service providers. They were owned by the municipalities, by the cities, villages, and the money went into the city budget. So it had quite significant income from these proceeds. Now there'll be these proceeds will be taken away from them. What are their reactions?
Well, the cities are very often against the reform that we have been helping implement, especially for those reasons, as you have mentioned. And cities are
obviously nobody wants to lose money.
Exactly. But the cities are also interested in votes in the upcoming elections. So the phenomenon that we see in Ukraine always before elections is that a substantial amount of money is being spent by cities for repair of de facto private property. So basically the government collects money from taxes from all of us, and then this money is being spent on repair of some of the privately owned buildings, which is wrong, which is very, very wrong, because this is just misuse of public money.
Yeah, so Mr. Gajda, very briefly, do you see this passing of the law as beneficial, and do you see that this means that Ukraine is on the right path towards reforming the residential energy consumption approach?
Yes, I do.
Well, Mr. Gajda, it looks like this reform is indeed taking place, and let's just hope that it will be done swiftly and effectively. Mr. Gajda, many thanks for finding the time to come and talk to us. This has been Vladimir Solov for Viewpoint, together with the project manager of the World Bank Group project, Ukraine Residential Energy Efficiency, Mr. Grzegorz Gajda. Thank you for watching us.